Your weekend entertainment begins Friday night on ITV when Bob Monkhouse and Mr. Babbage play host to two more families seeking their family fortunes. Then at 7:30, The Fall Guy.
Mr. Riker, I expect you to be back in my office by noon with the security against the bond.
I understand.
And Howie, I expect you to make sure that he's in my office with the money. Here's his dossier.
It's no problem. I know Colt's tricks. I've learned it all.
Howie, he's leaving.
An hour later at 8:30, Harvey Moon gets 10 out of 10 for trying it on with Stanley's schoolteacher.
Hi, Stan. Your dad was French kissing teacher. Mrs. White, on the lips.
You're lying.
Stanley found out about you canoodling with his teacher, that toffee-nosed cow of an headmistress. I'd like to know what you give her for Christmas.
You can talk.
Shine on Harvey Moon at 8:30, and that's how the start of your weekend looks on ITV.
The late horror film at 11 tomorrow offers a stroll in Torture Garden in the company of Jack Palance, Peter Cushing and Burgess Meredith. But be warned, some rather nasty things grow there.
And if the whole world fell in love, just like me and my girl, this would be beautiful. This would be so beautiful.
Man and woman, because the more you know, the closer you feel.
Something old, something new, something borrowed, something blue. My very first Lenore. Wonder if my lot will even notice.
They'll notice. Lenore gives your whole wash a deep down softness and a special April freshness.
Can I borrow your sweater again? Hey!
It's lovely and gentle. The extra softness. She noticed.
Smells great.
The April freshness. He noticed.
My shirt is terrific.
Even Jane. Oh.
There's a softness, an April freshness. I simply can't ignore. That's the loving touch of your love.
It's not just a unique atmosphere that makes a visit to Hancock so enjoyable. There's beer you can really taste, like Grünhalle Lager, and a superb choice of good food and wine. Hancock's Market Street Eastern, the most talked about restaurant for miles around, and open 7 days a week.
Don't leave your bathroom or lavatory window open when you go out. It's probably close to a drain pipe and makes it easy for thieves to gain entry. Be secure.
Now here's the weather forecast. The night will be fine and cold with widespread ground frost, the air temperature falling to around 1 degree centigrade. Tomorrow will begin dry and sunny but becoming cloudy, and rain will probably spread into western counties in the late afternoon or early evening. Highest temperature tomorrow 10 degrees centigrade. Winds will be light westerly tonight, force 3 to 5 at sea. Tomorrow winds will be southerly, light at first, becoming fresh or strong. Over the sea, force 3 or 4, increasing to force 5 to 7. That's the forecast. In company tonight, Ken talks to Bridget and her husband, Adrian.
Yes. This is this enormous marathon, which is on the 9th of May, and a few of the people at the Children's Centre where I work were hoping to go in for it. I think, in fact, one has had his entry turned down. But yeah.
This is the thing, the disaster. Did you see it last year?
Yes, we did.
You know, the thing I think so frightening about that is that if you're actually in the marathon, you know, it's all right if you're winning, but if you get lame or, you know, get puffed or something, and all your friends are watching, there's old George!
Don't you think that applies to anything at all that you sort of commit yourself to, really? You do expose yourself, don't you? Like you were saying about when you become a Christian, and we were talking about how you tell people about it. It's a little bit the same, isn't it? As soon as you sort of wear, you know, give yourself a label that you are a Christian, you've exposed yourself, really. The thing that fascinates me about this is the way that you can see the different sorts of training that people have had, you know, how some people have obviously prepared for it, they've got the right kit and everything else, and I think that's a little bit like a race as well, in fact, a little bit like the Christian race. Well, it's a bit like mine, anyway, because I hadn't prepared at all, really. Almost as soon as I became a Christian, we both felt that we'd been called to leave theatre school and go into social work. But I didn't pray about the specific job. I just write social work, get the right magazines, find a job. Off I went, had an interview, got the job, charged off to this place, and I was sure I'd be able to do it because I was a Christian and therefore God would help me.
And you felt that it was because you were a Christian you ought to do this? You
mean? Oh, yes, I did. Yes. But what I hadn't realised was that I just hadn't learned how to let God help me. I'd been used for years to standing on my own feet, and when I got into a difficult situation particularly, that's when I was going to do it on my own, because when you're at your most vulnerable, one of the problems is that you often do try and do it on your own, don't you? All your defences come up. And when I got there, the situation was quite beyond me, you know. There were lots of very, very tough girls. It was very much the end of a line place. Actually, you don't find places like this now, thank goodness.
Still find tough girls.
Yeah, but you don't find places that run like this, and it was a horrific experience, really, and quite alien to me. And what I wasn't realising was that while I was charging after these girls who were running away and never catching them and hoping I wouldn't because I didn't want to do them anyway, that in fact things were happening quite badly inside me.
It was horrific.
Adrian didn't really realise it to the full extent, did you?
But when I did realise it, I got very troubled indeed, because knowing Bridget, she wouldn't want to leave, you see,
yes,
because she wouldn't want to
wouldn't
fail.
Want to let God down. Yes.
That's right, yeah. And in fact, I had a letter from a friend saying there were two vacancies in a Christian healing home, and I thought, Christian healing home? You know, why would we want to go there? But then, of course, I didn't realise what was happening to Bridget. I realised what it was, and in fact I went into a church in Tunbridge Wells and I sat in the front pew and I was praying, and I said, well, when I come out of this church, if you really want us to go to this place, I want to meet such and such a person who I hadn't seen for a long time. And when I came out, I was feeling total disbelief, as one does on these occasions,
yes,
often.
Yeah.
There was that person standing in front of me.
It was a very specific laying down of a fleece, wasn't it?
Yes.
I mean, it's not something actually that one. I think you can do at random.
No.
But this was a real problem, and Adrian needed proof because he knew it was going to be tricky trying to move me. Yes.
So you've got the proof. So what happened then?
Well, then I phoned Bridget and I said, "I'm afraid you've got to go." And she said, "Why?" And I said, "Because God says so."
Yes.
I don't think she'd have taken my word for it.
But I didn't take God's for a bit either. I mean, well, for an evening, put it that way. I struggled about it, I argued about it, I was sure it couldn't be right, because it didn't fit in with my idea of the way I felt I was there, I should be doing a good job. But I did finally agree to go, and it was only when I got to the healing home that I collapsed, really, and that we realised just that I was, in fact, under an enormous strain,
yes,
and was about to have a breakdown.
You've been doing it in your
strength. I've been doing it in my strength.
Yeah.
And what God did was in 3 months made me fit enough for us to then go to another school where we learnt to grow up, apart from anything else, as Christians, where we learnt what His love can do, and as people, and where we learnt about the job of social work as well, so that we could start to do it, you know, and that we could learn to listen to Him when we were in a fix, you know, and to talk to Him when we were in a fix, and not to that fear to close us up so we couldn't be helped.
What you're really saying then, it's rather like with the marathon. It's no use starting out on the Christian life unless you get a bit of preparation, and just by becoming a Christian,
yes,
it's going to take
things,
time.
And to do things in God's time, I think, as well, because for some people it is right. They do get given the chance to go straight off, you know, and do something. But other people, they're not ready, and he knows that.
Keeping us company tonight were Ken Gardner and Bridget and Adrian Plass. We're the time at 19 and a half minutes to 1 o'clock. On this Thursday night, Television South is closing down. We're back on the air at 9:30 in the morning, and we look forward to you joining us sometime throughout the day. For now, from all of us here, have a peaceful night. Good night. If you're still there, don't forget, switch off the set. Good night.